Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. Hope you are doing really well. In today's video, I would like to describe about a very popular play which was written by David Mamet and it is Glengarry Glen Ross. Let me start without any delay. This play was written by Mamet in 1983. And this play won Pulitzer Prize in 1984. In this particular play, David Mamet wants to show about the failure of American dream and he also wants to expose the evil nature of capitalism. But as we have different people have different perspective, we can give our one theme after studying this particular play. Let me begin with the major character before telling you the summary because it will be very easy for you to understand it. Let me describe the major characters and the major characters here in this play are salesmen. There are four salesmen. First is Levin and second is David Moss. Third is Ricky Roma and fourth is Arno. These all are the salesmen of the real estate. And Williamson, he is the supervisor of this estate. And the boss is Mitch, the boss are Mitch and Murray. The customers are like Lynx is there and Nyron couple are there. And there is also a police detective, is Balan. And these all are the major characters. Now let's proceed toward the summary of this play. This play consists of two acts. And in first act, there are three scenes and in second act, it is single. In the first act, in the three scenes, there is a conversation between two persons in each scene. In the first scene, there is conversation between Levin and Williamson, the supervisor of the real estate. Levin is a salesman and now he is old. And when he was young, he used to get best lead and he used to have lot of money, but now due to his age, he does not succeed in selling it. And the company, the supervisor provides him the worst lead, and that is Glen Ross. And at that time, Mitch and Murray and the company supervisor, they announced to provide the Cadillac car to the winner who could make high profit by selling, and fire those person who will be unable to sell those leads. And Levin, he was old, so he was becoming unhappy that he will be unable to sell the leads. So he requests Williamson to provide him the best lead as he provides to Ricky Roma. But he does not agree, so he tries to bribe him to give the commission. But Williamson, in return, he asks money in advance. He could not give, so this conversation end like this, without any kind of hope for Levin. In second scene, there is conversation between the two salesmen, Dave Moss and Arno. Dave Moss and Arno, they are also the salesmen who could not sell their leads, and they are unsatisfied by their company. Dave Moss was a little bit criminal minded because he was angry in nature, so he wants Arno to steal the best lead from the office. But Arno does not agree. So, Dave Moss, he says Arno that if he does not steal the lead from the office, he will steal himself. But when the policeman come there and asks about it, he will tell the name that Arno is his partner. And in this way, this conversation ends in second scene. And in third scene, there is conversation between Link is conversating with Ricky Roma. Ricky Roma wants Link to buy the leads and he is convincing him. And at last, he became successful to convince, and he convinced him and take his signature, and he final the deal and goes to office. And in second act, what happened is that the supervisor of the company, Williamson, he finds that the leads were stole by someone, and he calls the police. In similar sense, and in one side, Link come there in office because his wife does not want him to buy the deal, and she wants him to cancel the deal, so she send him to the office. And when Ricky Roma sees Link, he suspect that he might come to cancel, so he says that the deal is not filed. But later on, this plan was unsuccessful as Williamson come there and he ruins his plan. Roma was unhappy and she scold the supervisor Williamson. And Levin was also there, and he suspect Williamson suspect that Levin might be the robber. When police come there, Levin disclose that he and Deb Moss are the thieves. Later on, Roma was unknown that Levin was arrested, so she wants to make Levin his partner. But Levin was taken, and this play ends like this. Yeah, the first thing we learn from this play, or the play might be trying to tell about the failure of the American dream. In this particular play, Levin could not speak well. He stammers frequently, and he stops while talking. He does not have proper persuasive power. But on the other hand, Ricky Roma, he uses the philosophical tone. He know about how to persuade people. So he was successful. And even though Levin worked hard, he could not get success. And this shows the failure of the American dream. As we know that according to American dream, a beggar can be a rich person if he labors hard, and a rich person can be poor if he does not labor. But here just opposite thing happened. Those who can speak like Ripke can get success. Those who cannot work like Levin became unsuccessful. And second thing we can find in this play is that it also shows that money is masculinity. Generally, when we talk about masculinity, it is physical power, but here it is not physical power, but it is money itself. And this play also talks about how there is division of people in society. The boss of company, Mitch and Murray, they exploit Williamson, the supervisor. The supervisor exploits the salesman, and finally the salesman exploits the customers. Here we can get the idea that the people who are exploited exploits other. These are the main theme of this play. Hope you like this video, and if you find this video helpful, please don't forget to subscribe my channel for more videos. Thank you so much. See you in next video. Bye-bye. Have a good day.